Hi everyone, welcome back. Hey, all month long, we are having a block party here. We're talking about friendship. That's right, and everyone's invited, okay? So, boy.
Are you excited about this?
I'm excited.
Okay, I love parties, and no party is complete without music and dancing. That's right. And here's the thing, Jordan, I know that dancing is not your favorite thing. Yeah, I had to force him to dance at our wedding, but not like that. Yeah. So I'm going to help you out today because friendship is all about how we use our words and our actions to love somebody. And right, that's how we love in a friendship. So yeah. I'm going to show you some love today and I'm going to help you dance.
Perfect.
Yep.
I need some new dance moves.
I think you could use it, right? So just like in Proverbs 17:17, it says that a friend loves at all times and they help us in times of trouble.
I need help.
You need lots of help.
Okay,
so I'm going to be there for you.
Okay.
All right. So all right. Stick around because after the so-and-so show and worship, we'll be back and we'll see how this
Check
goes.
Check this out.
How do you build a friendship? Some people think it's all about climbing the ladder of popularity or gathering the biggest number of followers on social media. Others believe it means throwing a birthday party at the best place so everyone will want to come, or even laughing along when someone makes a mean joke so that you can fit with the in crowd. But none of those things can promise you real friendship. Building true friendships is not about being in. It's about being the in for others. It's showing someone that you care about them and not just yourself. It's a smile and an encouraging word when someone in your class is having a bad day. It's making a spot at your lunch table for the kid who doesn't have a place to sit. It's inviting a new kid to your birthday party, even if it's just in the backyard. It's taking time to make your own get well card for the kid in your small group who broke his leg. When you choose to be a friend, you create a safe, welcoming place for others. You'll discover you're building true friendships, and others will see God at work in your life. That's why friendship is an amazing way to worship God with your life. Because worship is about more than just singing loud. It's all about living loud.
Jesus, you have been so faithful. Jesus, you have been so true. I will be forever thankful, 'cause I never had a friend like you. Help me to be who you've been to me, to everyone I see. Let us love one another with our love like no other yet. That's the way you love us, God. You with me in the darkest valley, you with me on the mountaintop. I'm thankful that you never leave me and that your love will never stop. Help me to be who you've been to me, to everyone I see. Let us love one another with our love like no other yet. That's the way you love us, God. For the way you love me all my life.
How you doing? You got everything? Did you bring them?
You know it. Oh. How about you?
Of course, buddy.
Then let's do this thing.
All right. Hit it. Yeah. All right. Build. Oh, yeah. Go. Let's go. Woo. Ow. That's hard and it hurt. Woo.
Are you sure this is how you have a block party? Hello, everyone. I'm Brandon.
And I'm John. And this is
the So-and-So Show. On this show, John and I hang out here talking together about the world we live in. We learn a little something about God, and then we discover what it means to be human.
Man, we do all that? We're good.
I know. And today's no different. We've got a fun day planned, and we're going to get started with a little game we like to call the $1,000 Triangle. John, show me the money. You don't have the money?
I spent it all on olives.
What? Never mind. Okay, today we're going to play a little game called the $25, $26, $27, $28, and $0.31 Triangle.
It's time for the $28.31 Triangle.
All right, here's how the game works. I'm going to try and get John to guess the answer on each of these cards. Shouldn't be too tough because the category is famous duos, people or things that go together. John, are you ready to play $28.31 Triangle?
You bet I am, Brandon.
Then let's play. Okay, here we go. Number one, okay, this is something that you write with and something that you write on.
Oh, a chisel and stone tablet.
No, it's a little more modern than that.
Oh, a finger and an iPad.
No, okay, think about this. This is very common. It's something you write with, something you write on. These are two things that go together. They are...
Mortal and pestle.
No, what? Pass, next one. All right, okay, you can get this one. This is, okay. These are two things that taste great between two slices of bread.
Oh, what is anchovies and mayonnaise?
No.
Oh, ketchup and sugar.
Okay, it's one of the most famous sandwiches you can think of.
To all beef patties, special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions, on a sesame seed bun.
Famous duos.
Oh.
Pass. Oh, my.
Vladimir and Estragon?
Yeah. All right, these are two of the coolest guys on the planet.
Who's Thomas Alva Edison, who invented the incandescent light bulb, and Sammy Hagar?
No, these two guys, they have a lot of fun every week and help teach people about God and the Bible.
Oh, Mel Solomon and Greg.
No, these two guys are the hosts of the So-and-So Show.
Stephen and Lawson?
No, it's the people hosting the show right now. Right now, they're also playing the game, $28.31. Triangle. They are. It's me and you, John. Me and you.
Oh.
Unbelievable.
I was so close.
You only got one right.
But who eats peanut butter with jelly?
Me. It's Bible story time with Kellen.
Oh, man.
Hello, my friends. How's it going?
Pretty good, Kellen. John didn't know we were a famous duo.
Oh, I thought we were a famous trio.
Hey, you're right.
That's why I missed it.
Yeah. What story do you have for us today?
Well, speaking of duos, today I want to talk about one of the most famous duos in history, David and Jonathan. And to help me do that, please welcome the So-and-So Show players. Jonathan was the prince of Israel.
Hi, I'm Jonathan.
And his dad, King Saul, was the very first king of Israel.
I am king.
David was Jonathan's best friend.
Hi, I'm David.
He killed Goliath.
He was a really mean giant.
David was a national hero, and everyone loved him.
Oh, stop.
And... don't tell Saul and Jonathan this, but God had decided that David was going to be the next king of Israel.
What'd he say?
I'm just telling the story. Still, Jonathan loved David, and he gave his friend gifts that were good enough for a prince.
Here, friend. It's my bow and arrow.
Thank you, best friend.
And my princely tunic.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
For you. And my favorite pillow, my favorite soccer ball.
Thank you.
Hold on. There's more to come. And all of the important things. You'll sleep well with him.
Thank you.
This will help you in a jam.
Thank you.
And this will always provide the light just the way you want it.
Oh, thank you.
Jonathan probably didn't give David a lampshade, but you get the idea. They were best friends. Unfortunately, King Saul was jealous of David because everyone liked him so much. So King Saul sort of wanted to kill David.
Why did your dad want to kill me? What did I do?
Well, he's not going to kill you. Dad tells me everything. He wouldn't keep something like that from me.
Maybe he didn't tell you because he knows how close we are.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. What do you want me to do?
I'm supposed to eat with the king at the new moon feast tomorrow. Tell them that I couldn't make it. And if he gets mad, then you'll know for sure he's trying to kill me. Can you do that?
Yeah, I'll do it. I'll do it.
Wait. How will I know how your father reacts?
I have an oddly over-elaborate plan that might just work. Mm-hmm. You see that stone out there?
Yes.
I want you to wait by that stone. After the feast, I'll come out with a servant, and I'll shoot 3 arrows into the field. And if everything is okay, I'll say, look, the arrows are on this side of you. And if I find out that Dad wants to kill you, I'll say, look, the arrows are far, far beyond you. And if I say that, then you definitely need to run. Okay? All right? Got it? Okay.
Why wouldn't you just send your servant out there to tell me?
There's no time for discussion, okay? The game is at foot. Let's go. Good.
Okay.
The plan was in place. Everything was set. David had chosen not to eat with the king at the new moon feast. The only question was, how would King Saul react? Well, on the second night of the feast, King Saul noticed something was missing.
Son?
Yes, father?
Where?
Yes.
Is?
Yes?
The catsup!
It's right here. Right, it's right here.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
And,
thank
you. I believe it's pronounced ketchup, last I heard.
Huh. Yeah, well, the more you know. Also, where?
Yes, father.
Is?
Yes, the mustard. It's right there.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you. No problem.
There's a little red, a little yellow. Makes a very happy fellow. Very good. Now, son.
Yes, father.
Where's David?
He wanted to go visit his family, so I let him go.
What? Now, do you not realize that as long as he is alive, you will never be king? David must die!
But he hasn't done anything!
King Saul was so angry, he grabbed a spear and threw it at his own son.
I'm going to throw this spear at you.
No.
You best run!
No!
You best run!
Not a pickle spear, an actual spear. But whatever. The spear missed Jonathan, and Jonathan had all the information that he needed. King Saul wanted to kill David. So it was time to send David the signal.
Come, unnamed servant from the Bible. Let's shoot some arrows into the field for no mysterious reason whatsoever.
Shall I make the sound, sire?
Oh, shall you make the sound? Don't you always make the sound?
Very good.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Very good. Very good.
Mm-hmm. Good. Excellent marksmanship, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Very good. Now, run out into the field and collect those arrows.
But they're just right there.
Go!
Okay.
Hurry! Run fast! Don't stop! The arrows are far beyond you!
I feel like you're not even looking at me.
Just go! Run!
Have I gotten there yet? Okay, got him. Yahtzee, all right.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Very well, lad. You take those weapons back to town.
Okay.
When the servant left, David came out of hiding and met his friend on the field one last time.
Get up. Get up. Promise me you'll always be kind to my family. Even after my father is gone?
I promise.
In the name of the Lord, you and I have made a promise to be friends. It's not only a promise between us, but between our children after us.
Yes.
Go in peace.
By protecting David that day, Jonathan saved the life of the future king of Israel. But more importantly than that, he saved his friend. The end. How about a hand for the so-and-so show players?
Wow, what an incredible story.
I know, Jonathan was a prince, so by saving David, he was basically giving up the throne.
And that's risking amazing. His life. I mean, Jonathan really laid everything on the line for his friend. Mm-hmm.
Well, that's what friends do, isn't it? They love each other. They're patient and kind. They protect each other and never give up on each other. It's like the Apostle Paul wrote in his letter to the Corinthians, love never fails.
Never? I'm not sure I'm that good of a friend. No offense.
No, I'm with you.
It's true. I think if we really want to love like a true friend, we're going to need God's help. He knows more about love than anyone. Well, think about it. He sent his son, Jesus, to die for us so that we would know how important we are to him. Talk about laying everything on the line.
Yeah, that's so true. Thanks, Kellen.
You bet. I'll catch you guys later.
See ya. Huh.
Bye, Kellen. So if God went out of his way to show us how important we are to him, and if Jonathan went out of his way to show David how important he was, what does that mean for us?
Don't ask me, ask them.
All right, reveal the question. How can you show your friends they're important? Yeah, what are some ways you can show your friends they're important to you?
Yeah, maybe give them a wrapped apple.
A wrapped apple?
Yeah, they're healthy.
Or maybe spend time with them.
Oh, you don't even have to wrap the apple if you don't want to, just...
Talk about it together. How can you show your friends they are important?
You know, you've never even once given me an apple.
I'm Brandon.
And I'm John.
And this was the So-and-So Show.
Not even mashed or sauced.
Why, you wouldn't want a mashed apple?
Absolutely.
Like
haven't you ever had a mashed apple? What are you doing, Brandon?
Well, I'm just taking a stroll around the block.
Boo, 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 boo. Hey, you know what this is?
Eh?
It's a chip off the old block. Oh. Hey, stop being a stumbling block.
I'll knock your block off.
Blockhead.
You got any more?
No, I've got writer's block.
First dance up is disco. Ready? And go. job. Next up, classical. Ready?
I'm doing it.
Nice. Next up is techno. Ready? And last but not least, Broadway. Ready? Jazz. Nice job, Jordan. You did it. Ready? Two thumbs up. I give you two thumbs up for that.
Oh, thanks for your help.
Well, that's what I'm here for. Friends help each other out. Love you.
I needed it.
Well, if you would love to see more, head on over to our Facebook page at our eKids Online or follow us on Instagram. We would love to see you. Are you ready to do some more dancing?
Let's do it. Robot.
All right, ready? Robot.
See you next week.